Buckle up. We're coming to you from deep in the heart of Texas, live from Dallas, home of AU Pro Women's Basketball. Thanks for spending the first day of Women's History Month with us. What is Athletes Unlimited Basketball, you ask? Well, let me tell you, we have got Team Sims taking on Team Hillman in the second half of our doubleheader. We had a fantastic finish in game number one as Team Smith was able to come back and beat Team Harrison by a deuce. So here is what we are dealing with AU Pro Women's Basketball. We have 44 world-class hoopers in an innovative scoring system. New teams are drafted each week by team captains, and the top 4 point scorers are named team captains, and the teams play each other once over a 4-day span. With that, we welcome you courtside here at the Fair Park Coliseum alongside the Hall of Famer. She is Cheryl Swoops. You know, a lot of gold medals and WNBA titles. Yeah, that Cheryl Swoops. I'm Cindy Brunson. Mariluz Cook is the third member of our broadcast team and will be joining us in just a bit. We had a barn burner of a fourth quarter in game number one. What do you expect to see here in game number two?
Listen, game one was just a warm-up. I'm expecting a lot of scoring, a lot of defense, and Odyssey Sims to tear it up.
Okay, Odyssey Sims, before the 40 piece that Izzy Harrison dropped, was AU's leading scorer. She is just lighting it up like a Christmas tree and also leads in assists as well.
Yeah, listen, Odyssey Sims did everything last week. To your point, she's averaging 23 points, 6 rebounds, and 13 dimes, and she flat out led her team last week and just scores in so many multiple ways. Putting it on the floor, getting to the hole, and by the way, she is going to flex just a little bit.
We like the flex and we love the lashes. For Isabel Harrison, she was a veteran captain like Odyssey Sims. She took the loss against Nalissa Smith, a first-time captain. Guess what? Another first-time captain on top in Nas Hillman. And Nas just tears it up all over the stat sheet.
Yeah, so when you look at her numbers, she's averaging 9 points, 8 rebounds. So you say, well, how is she in the top 4? It's because she does the dirty work. She does the little things. She can score. She's going to run into transition. She gets to the hole, can finish at the hole, and oh yeah, she's going to crash the boards. She's going to defend every position, and Nas Hillman is one of those players that can just flat out play, and she does all the little things for her team to win.
Grab your popcorn, settle into your easy chair. We've got a lot to watch out for, including the leaderboard, next on WNBA League Pass and the Women's Sports Network.
Back when we were just kids, we wondered, what's the future for me?
For me. For me.
For me.
For the game that I love. The team in my dreams. The field, the court, the arena I long to play in. The answer? It's here. For me. For them. For the ones with the heart to play. With voices that are too powerful to be silenced, and with skills that only champions possess. A future. Unlimited.
Every moment counts in Athletes Unlimited.
All these athletes are going to lay it all out on the line.
Oh my goodness! She is spectacular!
All I can say is wow.
Highlight film stuff.
It's more than a medal, it's more than a game. We're trailblazing, and we know that.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Elizabeth McWhirter.
Welcome back to the Fair Park Coliseum. Taking a look at the team STEM starters for you. Jordan Canada, Odyssey Sims, Lexi Hull, Kirsten Bell, and Jamaris Davis. For Team Hillman, it'll be Lexi Brown, Alicia Gray, Leija Clarendon, Nas Hillman, and Teresa Plaisance. Who do you like in this game, Cheryl?
Listen, it's hard for me to go against Team Sims. Mm-hmm. Odyssey just, she showed out last week. She just does so many things for her team. But the other side of that, when I look at Team Hillman, they got some offense. You got Alicia Gray, Lexi Brown, Teresa Plaisance. You talk about some shooters.
Well, our friends at the Caesar Sportsbook like Team Sims over Team Hillman by 5.5 points. FYI, Caesars had the winner in game one as Team Smith, correct? A little off on the line. Team Smith won by 2. They predicted 3.5. So definitely something to keep an eye on. Our officiating crew is KD Bunger, Cam Garber, and Grant Dietrich. And we are ready to jump it up. The team wearing purple, led by Nas Hillman, the first time captain, winning the tip. Gray, the top pick in both drafts so far here in AU Pros Hoops. Plaisance for 3. Back iron, battle for the rebound. And that is won by Jamaris Davis.
And Jamaris Davis was a nice surprise last week, putting up some great numbers, playing hard. She, too, is a rebounding machine.
Odyssey Sims wanted to go inside. Ball is tipped, but it will stay with the team in goal. Sims getting it out to Jordan Canada. It'll be interesting because you basically have 2 point guards on the floor with Sims and Canada.
Yeah, which is, oh, that's nice. Good deep. Yeah, to your point, that's the same thing that we had last week with Natasha Cloud and Jordan Canada. It was interesting to see who was going to run the show and have the ball in their hands the most. And Nas,
nice
Hillman.
Finish. Hillman getting the party started for the team in purple. We saw a first-time captain win in game one in Alyssa Smith. Somehow, she was able to overcome foul trouble and a double-digit deficit. And her team came back to get the win. Ooh, Odyssey Sims almost jumped in Cheryl's lap.
I was ready.
I know you were. It will stay with the team in purple, Nas Hillman's crew. The scoring in game number one did not disappoint. Izzy with a career-high 40 points in AU Pro Women's Basketball. She also had a dozen rebounds.
Yeah, Izzy was putting in work.
Gray off the mark. Clarendon there for the rebound. They're trying to get a step on Canada. Doesn't work, but it will stay with Team Purple.
Jordan Canada was another player last week. And, you know, we talked about this, and I told you, I think that was the first time I've seen her play in person. And if you haven't seen her play, you are missing out on one talented baller.
Right? Lexi Hull almost came up with the turnover. Now the shot clock only has 3 seconds on it. Both point guards put up the number 3, so you know they're paying attention for Team Gold. And it will be ball out of bounds on the side.
3 seconds. Yeah. And not only did Jordan impress me with her offensive ability and her speed and quickness, defensively, she can lock somebody down.
Lexi Brown has her shot blocked, and that's a shot clock violation. So it will be Team Gold basketball led by Odyssey Sims. Lexi's like, that doesn't happen to me very often.
I'm going to say shot clock was running down. But Lexi Hull, don't get it twisted. Lexi Hull can defend.
Yes. Canada calling out the play. Bell for 3. Brown with the rebound ahead to Clarendon. They are on the run until Lexi Hull stops the dribble. Stripped by Sims. Odyssey.
Ooh,
touch pass from Canada. Oh, no. Davis Bulls couldn't finish. That touch pass was a thing of beauty from JC. It will be gold basketball.
Oh, Damaris, I need you to finish that one.
Right?
Oh, that was beautiful.
Just lush. Ty Young checking into the game for the first time.
Listen, that's one point guard to another point guard. Oh. She said, no, you take it. Oh, that's so beautiful.
So it will be Team Hillman in purple with the basketball, and Hillman scored every point so far in the game.
Well, you know, we talked about in the open, Nas Hillman does just so many little things that, and with AU basketball, rebounds are points, steals are points, blocks are points, and those are the categories that Nas Hillman is very impressive in besides the scoring and the rebounding.
So it'll be Gray ticketed with the personal foul, sending Young, the OG, to the free throw line.
She
appeared in all 15 games of the inaugural season of AU Pro Hoops, scored in double figures five times, and is averaging 12.5 points coming into this game this season.
Yeah, Ty, especially in Sunday's game, Ty stepped up for her team and was very impressive in that game.
Oh, that's a nice lay. Clarendon gets the finish. They are on the board with 2 points, and somebody besides Hillman has now scored. For the team in purple, Teresa Plaisance ticketed for the personal foul. She doesn't agree with the call.
So for anyone out there that's watching the game, young boys, young girls, Odyssey Sims does such a great job of keeping her dribble alive until she's ready to pass it, shoot it, or do something. She very rarely picks it up and stands there with it like, what am I going to do with it?
Okay, so that Smith bucket does not count. They got a personal foul against Ty Young underneath. That's a bummer because that triple was nice. And you know Odyssey's going, you just took 30 points out of my pocket for a made three.
Like,
don't do that to me, OG. Don't do that to me.
No, she's like, you owe me.
Young with a beautiful rebound. Here comes Team Sims in gold. JC thought she had a step until Gray put her on lock. Young, jumper, in and out. Who would not have it? Lexi Hull goes flying. Lexi Brown with the ball, looking for teammates in purple.
Team Sims, they've had some unlucky breaks.
Gray, mouse in the house with JC on her, and she earns a trip to the free throw line as well.
Gold medalish. That's tough. Nice little post up. She said, I got a little post up game. And because she's a lefty, I found it's a lot harder to guard lefties than it is righties.
Why do you think that is?
Because there are more righties in the world than lefties.
Okay. It just breaks it down to basic math.
Yeah.
I'll take that.
Well, Alicia Gray on that last play, she squared up and you think she's going right. But because she's a lefty, she comes back left for a nice finish.
Speaking of nice, Odyssey Sims says, you can't take that 30 points away from me. She gets that triple to go. Alicia Gray off the mark. Great defense by Lexi Hull. If I had a dollar for every time I said that sentence, I could retire.
We would retire together.
Right? I mean, Lexi Hull just brings it. I hope the youngsters at home are paying attention. That's how you earn playing time.
Yes.
In this league, the W, the NBA, college, it don't matter. If you defend like Hull, you will play.
Yeah, and Lexi Hull found herself in the top 10 of the draft this week.
Mm.
So obviously, not only did you and I notice, Nas Hillman noticed as well.
100%.
Odyssey Sims.
Yes, Sims to the free throw line. She gets the first one to go. No surprise there. An 81% free thrower here in season two of AU Pro Women's Hoop.
she gets them both. And still, the most impressive stat for me from Odyssey in week one was the assists, leading everybody nearly 13 a game.
Yeah. And it didn't take away from her scoring a
bit. No, because she led the league in scoring last week, too.
Yeah. And she was distributing, she was scoring, she was getting buckets.
They, with the nice find, Plaisance with the finish. Bell for three. Okay, shooter's touch.
I told you, my mom said, you're living right.
She averaged 14.3 points a game in week one of AU Pro Women's Basketball. She's a newbie, as is Hillman. Nice box out by Bell. Canada trying to get ahead of everybody. Plaisance with a nice hustle. Clarendon dishing to Gray. Back to Hillman. What a fast break.
Another nice little touch pass from Gray to Hillman.
Sims with the first step, can't get the finish. Young, no, she blows the bunny, and Hillman is there for the rebound. Miss opportunity by Team Sims there, point blank.
And Leigh does a nice job of knowing when to push the ball in transition, when to walk it up, making sure that she has her teammates involved in the offense.
Quintessential point guard.
Yeah.
Okay, Bell, how about three ball number six on the young season for Kirsten Bell. With that, we're going to step aside.
Yeah. And Nas Hillman did a phenomenal job with her draft. And it all starts with Leija Clarendon pushing in transition. Nice touch pass from Gray to Hillman. Come back.
There's power in my voice.
When I use it.
To speak up for a cause.
To encourage the person next to me.
To help us hear the voiceless.
To represent my people.
To shine a light on the truth.
To show others what is possible.
To change the course of history.
To remind you of the power in yours.
There is power in your voice,
but only when you use it.
What jumps out at you?
That gave me goosebumps.
Mitchell. Gracious Tosh.
I don't even know what to say except, ooh.
You want to see bucket getters all over the floor? Check and check. And Lexi Brown with the dagger.
What an exciting time to be an athlete, to be a woman. Not only have we arrived, but we are here to stay.
Athletes Unlimited Basketball is brought to you by the Air National Guard. To learn how you can serve your way, head to goang.com. Welcome back to Fair Park Coliseum, where if you like offense,
then you can salute those who participated in the Week 2 draft. You're looking at Week 2 captains, and Izzy Harrison, one of them, and boy, did she have herself a day. A career-high 40 points, 12 rebounds, finished third in the MVP vote with the third most points in AU history, hello. And her team took the loss. Your reaction, Cheryl Swoops?
Izzy had a game. But third in MVP, I get they didn't win. Mm-hmm. So she's probably not going to get first.
Right.
But
a 40 piece.
You got to at least give her a second.
Mm. They did not. They did not agree with you. So we're back to action, where all five starters wearing purple had an assist already. That's 6 dimes on 6 made baskets. Ooh, Gray wasn't ready for that pass. Lexi Poe is not going to miss from there. New players on the floor for Team Purple, led by Nas Hillman, Air Hearn, as well as Christy Bellick. Lexi Brown.
Oh, good.
Bouncing
pass
to Bella. That's a nice finish.
Mm-hmm. That's
another
pretty.
Another assist on a made basket. Team Nas Hillman with the lead, 15 to 14. Corner three, Hull, no. Battle for the rebound, won by Gray. There is not a single thing she doesn't do well on the basketball floor.
Well, she just plays hard. Mm-hmm. Every possession, doesn't matter what the score is, you're going to know that Alicia Gray is on the floor. Just like you're going to know Lexi Hull's on the floor. Defensively, she's long, she's active, turning her defense in the offense for two.
Oh, by the way, Lexi Hull is the Week 1 blocks leader with 7 coming into today.
So y'all learn something from you every day.
Odyssey Sims off the mark, but the basketball will stay with her team wearing gold. Down 1 point in the game and here in the first quarter. The winner after 1 quarter gets 50 leaderboard points per every individual on the roster. Oh, getting it to Davis. Nice step through, but she can't finish. And so Team Hillman wearing purple with an opportunity to add to its lead. 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter of play. Hillman doesn't get that shot to fall. Didn't get the foul call either. Sims. Ooh, little shake and bake.
Good pass.
Avoiding the double team beautifully with the backup dribble. In honor of celebrating Black women's history, be sure to check out our exclusive merchandise, including a shirt designed by Kaya on Khalid, who specializes in creating art that highlights and amplifies the dynamic nature of Black culture. Go to shop.auprosports.com to purchase yours today. Another turnover by Team Sims will give Team Hillman the basketball. And Team Hillman in purple with the lead, 15-14. 2 minutes to go here in this first quarter. 50 leaderboard points on the line per player. Nice bounce pass to Bella. And she can't get the finish, but will earn a trip to the free throw line.
So that's the second play in a row. They ran the exact same play. The only difference was Air Hearn made the bounce pass instead of Lexi Brown.
Ty Young getting set to check back into the game, as in Jordan Canada at the scorer's table. Air Hearn coming up to fill in the low block on the free throw. The referee kindly noticed, hey, you might want another free, another person on the block here. Bella gets the first free throw to go. That's her first trip to the free throw line this AU Pro Hoop season. So now she can stay perfect. Davis takes a seat, replaced by Akila Mays. Bella perfect at the free throw line. 2 for 2 on the young season. It's a 3-point lead with 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Nice bounce pass to Ty Young. Terrific defense by Danny McCray, too, who has also checked into the game. 6'1" product out of Ole Miss, wearing number 73.
She had a nice week one.
Yeah, and I was going to say, anytime Danny McRae gets an opportunity to get in the game and play, she does some really good things for her team.
Lexi Brown doesn't get the bounce. Jordan Canada with the rebound, and she's looking for teammates in gold. Oh, come on. Wow, that's textbook fast break.
Honestly, you know, last week I talked about, to me, what was most impressive is just her growth and her leadership. And she continues to impress me with just how well she's running her team, distributing the basketball, not intentionally looking for hers, but she's able to get hers and get everybody else involved. Jordan Canada pushing in transition, finding Odyssey, and Odyssey says, no, I see you, OG. I see you running the floor.
A perfect example of if you run, you will be rewarded.
Yeah. And especially when you have 2 point guards like Odyssey and Jordan, they're going to find you.
So it is Team Hillman with the lead, 17-16. Odyssey recognizing, getting it to Ty Young. She's off the mark, point blank range. Air Hearn with the rebound, getting it to Clarendon. They have just checked back into the game. Clarendon. Inside to McRae, double team comes, and it doesn't matter. McRae is going to the free throw line.
Well, you know, Cindy, that was one thing you and I talked about before the game was Team Sims, when you look at the draft, do they have enough size? And that particular play, Danny McRae said, no, they don't. And she posts up and says, I'm going to finish and go to the free throw line.
Team Purple now with 14 paint points. They are living in the lane.
Well, just like we noticed and talked about it, you have to know that every other team coming into the game when they're playing Team Sims, they feel like that's where their advantage is going to be.
Team Hillman on top 20-16 with the first quarter winding down, 50 quarter points per player on the line. Canada swings it to Sims for three. Front rim, Bellick is there for the good rebound. Smartly, she waits for Clarendon as they come around to avoid the long reach of Lexi Holt. No 2-for-1 situation here as the game clock is double that of the shot. Clarendon, no, big rebound by JC, and Canada is on the run, bouncing to Lexi Holt. She's got a step, leaves it short, but picks up the personal foul.
Love that combination. Odyssey, JC, Lexi Hall getting out in the lane, filling the lane. Jordan, and I can't say it enough, JC or Odyssey, either one of them will find you if you get out and run.
Lexi Hall had the second most made three-pointers in week one with 7. She stays perfect at the free throw line, and she had a MVP 1 award last week worth 90 points on the way to 697 total on the leaderboard, fourth most in AU Pro Women's Basketball history.
Lexi Hall, she made a name for herself last week as well. It's nice to see the newcomers come into the league and adjust so quickly. That was just week one. I can only imagine what week 2, 3, 4, 5 are going to be like.
Right. Team Hillman able to win the first quarter 20-18 and the 50 leaderboard points that go with it. That's why Lay and Bellick weren't pushing the basketball up the floor. They knew they had the quarter win and were ready to pocket those 50 points. What's going to happen in quarter two? We'll find out together on WNBA League Pass.
I'm the chairperson of the PEC, Player Executive Committee. I've been involved since, you know, the inception of this league. We started getting involved in calls early on.
So we're working on everything from uniforms to location and where people are going to live and what our schedules are going to look like, what kind of programming we want, what do we want as athletes out of the experience. As the PEC, we're speaking for the entire athlete group.
We make any decision, small or large, in conjunction with the league. They are awesome and they totally have our backs in everything that we do.
It's just a lot of work when no one's watching.
Pretty much every logistical decision that you think will be made about hosting a season in one location, like we were a part of those calls.
So I'm really pumped to see what all of our hard work will appear as.
Will probably be one of like the coolest achievements I ever have in my life.
Qualities is, I mean, we're going to be fast-paced, up and down. I don't want to have very many half-court sets. I just want to run you in transition, but also heavy on defense. Defense wins games. I mean, we have a lot of talented players here, and if you're not getting stops on defense, I mean, it's going to be an offensive battle, which, I mean, I can play into. I think my team can do it, but I'd like to get stops.
Naz Hillman, the first-time captain, leading her team with 6 points after the first quarter, where Team Hillman has a 2-point lead. For more on the superstar that's emerging here in AU Pro Women's Hoop, here's the third member of our broadcast team, Mariluz Cook.
Oh my goodness, a superstar she is. On one side of this game, we find Odyssey Sims, who is incredibly seasoned, returning as a captain in back-to-back weeks. And then we have the youngest athlete in the league here in Naz Hillman. Now, her teammates have been incredibly impressed and supportive of her leadership despite her age at 22. But her number one supporter here sitting courtside is her mom. With the help of teammate and number one draft pick Alicia Gray, Nishima, her mom, who was here last week, returned to Cleveland, her home, on Tuesday, but turned herself right around on this morning because she had to be here. She said, one, she had so much fun in Dallas for AU Pro Hoops, but two, she had to see the captain in purple. So with the help of Alicia Gray, she was able to return and surprise Naz today. Naz, who attended Michigan, said that she saw her from behind with the Michigan backpack and freaked out when she saw her mom. But so, so special to get to be here sitting courtside. You see her with a huge smile on her face, and she'll be here throughout the rest of week two.
Absolutely love that, Mariluz. Thanks so much for sharing. That is outstanding. And that's what this league is all about, an opportunity to play pro women's basketball, to do it in one location, to earn some bank, to stay safe stateside, and continue to play in front of friends and family.
Absolutely. And mom said, I got to come see my baby. Mm-hmm. Not just the captain. That captain is my baby. Mm-hmm. And it is. It's nice to be able to play in front of friends and play in front of family, and that's exactly what the opportunity that AU has provided.
Sims doesn't get the roll. The bunnies missed at the rim by the team in gold are stunning so far in this game.
There is a lid on that basket.
Davis coming up with the basketball on the steal. Jamaris, she's a pro hooper in Spain shortly before coming here to Dallas. And she has been fantastic here in AU Pro Hoops after week one. Odyssey says, I'm not gonna miss her there.
Well, Odyssey has that look on her face like, okay, we lost the first quarter, but we're not losing the quarter number two.
Right, I'm not losing any more chances to line my pockets. Taking a look at the live leaderboard, Nalissa Smith, way up there. You see Jordan Canada climbing as we look live. Positive plays net you points, negative plays take them away. Every player in our league has that running score, and points are awarded or deducted based on one's individual performance. But a player's biggest points boost comes from their team winning quarters and games. Canada for three. Oh, okay, JC.
You know, it's almost like, it's almost like the two-point guard said, okay, quarter one is going to be for everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
Quarter two, we're going to go to work a little bit.
We're going to eat.
Yeah.
So Team Sims with the lead until Gray hits that bunny. And so Team Hillman takes the lead back, 24-23. It is Team Sims leading in the quarter, though, by a single point. Yeah, we saw Team Melissa Smith come through with 250 points at the end of the game because we had a tie in the third quarter, so 100 points rolled over to quarter four, and then the game win for 150 points. I haven't seen a swing like that since last season. 250 points in the comeback.
Listen, Jordan Canada, again, she said, okay, I let everybody else eat the first quarter. It is my turn. Such a nice shot from deep. Jordan Canada, I would love to see her look for her shot a little bit more this quarter.
Have you heard her sing?
I have heard her sing.
It's almost as nice as that three ball.
She's got a nice voice.
Mm.
I heard her sing one of my favorite singer songs.
What's that?
Her, by her.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I heard her do a couple of her songs, and I was like, okay, Jordan.
Jordan with the bounce pass to Davis. Nice finish as Sims retakes the lead, 25-24 in the game. Plaisance trying to equalize, cannot for the quarter as Team Sims is up by three.
Yes.
Davis stripped, wanted a foul, didn't get it, but it will be Team Gold basketball.
And listen, if you're playing with Odyssey Sims or Jordan Canada, you better be ready to run.
Right?
Because they are going to get out. They are going to push the basketball. All you got to do is run and be ready.
Sims for three. Missing everything. Hillman is there for the rebound. That'll make moms happy. Hillman on the deck. Leaves it short. Chance for a rebound putback. No. Bell is there. Pearson has already hit a three, getting the bounce pass through the legs from Canada. Davis with the nice finish, long range jumper. I'm telling you, she gets better by the dribble.
Yeah, she looked like, finally I made one.
Well, I think like she was frustrated by not getting the foul call on the previous
For play. Sure. So you're saying that was a foul?
I'm saying she thought it was a foul. I'm gonna step away from that. I know she thought it was a foul. JC is working.
Yeah, Jordan Cannon, she could just do so many things. Nice between the leg pass to Bell, who finds Davis filling the lane for a nice jumper.
Jordan Cannon with 3 points and three dimes, a prototypical line for her, the product out of UCLA. Standing just 5'6" tall. But you know, Sparks fans have to be so happy that she is in LA and loving it.
A great place for her.
Almost a steal, but 11 seconds will be on the clock for Team Hillman. A reminder, we've got another season of Trees for Threes presented by Aspiration. For every three-pointer made during this year's Athletes Unlimited basketball season, Aspiration is committed to planting 10 trees. I think Kelsey Mitchell wants to plant a forest.
I'm sure she does.
They with the nice finish. Clarendon with a couple of nice buckets already. JC dribbling out of trouble, getting into Hull. Hull recognizing, finding Bell open for three. She kicks it in to Akila Mays.
That's nice.
Nice dish and finish.
Nice shot fake by Bell. Put it on the floor. Mays does a nice job of finding pass from Bell for two.
Mays getting some quality minutes here in the second quarter for Team Sims. Team Sims with the lead in the quarter, 11-6. Clarendon triple is true. They made that look easy.
It's like, y'all don't forget about me. I don't just distribute the ball.
Mays did not agree with that foul call. The look on her face. Woo! We've got more AU Pro Women's Basketball coming your way. We'll be right back.
set. There it is.
Colson from half court. For the win!
Helton lets it go. Stopped by Glenn. The first ever shootout in Athletes Unlimited Lacrosse.
And the final at bat for Amanda Chittister.
Club out of the left field line. Did she do it? She did!
Hawkins gets the victory in triple overtime.
This moment right here, can nobody take this one?
I'm thrilled tonight to help celebrate the career of a volleyball legend, number 13, Shayla Preston.
And that's going to do it for Daniel O'Toole.
Did she? She did!
Everybody celebrate, but this isn't over.
Every moment in a game can change, it can split in a second, it can alter the game in like one way or another, and I think that taking each moment to kind of like break down the game and work for the moments instead of just working for the end result and the game itself. Take it minute by minute, take it possession by possession. Those are the moments that are gonna matter.
I love the fact that you're gonna be awarded points on both ends of the floors. If I'm selling out on the defensive end, I can get just as many points for things as if I make a three or if I make a layup.
There's a lot going on in a game, especially as like a midfielder, like you're involved in every play.
I don't think a lot of people really realize that there's more to Athletes Unlimited than just these individual points.
Literally every moment, like on and off the field, plays a role in the chemistry piece, which is where you find the game wins.
When you're in the dugout, it's so amazing where you guys are constantly cheering, whether they're in the starting nine, whether they're coming in a pinch hit, pinch run. We're all contributing to the success of our team. We have to be unified as a team, which eventually leads to winning the game.
Back here at the Fair Park Coliseum in Dallas, Texas, it's Naz Hillman and Odyssey Sims, their teams respectively tied at 29. That Captain C looks pretty good on Hillman. Let's go into the game with Air National Guard.
Yep, I had your help. Make sure you have backside straight up on her.
She looks that big.
Yep. Hey, what do we want now? A lot of really good stuff in pick and roll action. They had no answer for it, whether that was the guard coming off for shots, whether that was the post player rolling. Make sure we're in the guard's vision to make sure that they know that we can see them. We're getting them make sure we're getting the ball.
That's just somebody coming off their rookie season.
Yeah.
I mean, that's impressive.
Well, it is impressive, especially for her being the youngest player here at AU and the fact that her older players, everybody's in the huddle, everybody's listening, and she made some very good points in that huddle.
100%. Clarendon leads all scorers with 9.
Just turn it up another notch.
That extra gear doesn't get her the bucket. Sims with the steal and the finish. Odyssey Sims quickly has 9. Sims scores in bunches. Odyssey Sims putting her team up 13-9 here in the second quarter. Plays on for 3 off the mark. Alicia Gray hits the deck hard. That sounded like it might leave a mark. Somebody has joined us in the chair chat. It is A.B. Bannister. I think you had a good look at that, A.B. How you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you guys doing?
What's up, A.B.?
Hey, Cheryl.
Hi. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. How excited are you for season 2 of AU basketball?
I'm super, super excited. More than anything, I'm just truly grateful, you know, to be back for season 2 because it's a lot of talent out here. You know, I'm just grateful to be here and just learning, you know, learning from a lot of girls that I looked up to and, you know, just want to be like and just making these different connections. So more than anything, I'm just grateful to be here. But I love AU. AU is great.
Blazons hits the triple to beat the buzzer. AB, who do you want to model your game after most?
Honestly, I would say like Natasha Cloud. just watching her last year, she reminded me a lot of myself. Just, you know, she plays with a lot of passion. She's very competitive, you know, and she's just very energetic. And, you know, she always getting her teammates involved, you know, just she brings that energy to the court. And, you know, that's the kind of player I like to be. And so just watching her, like, I just try to, you know, immaculate the way that she plays. She's great. I love the way that Tosh plays and the way she just gets everyone involved in the game.
So, AB, I have a question for you. For, like,
all
of the kids, not even kids, just players out there who may be tuning in watching, you know, everybody wants to start. Everybody wants to play a lot of minutes.
Right.
What advice, because when you get in the game, you contribute, you bring it, you're probably not playing as many minutes as you would like to play.
Yes, ma'am.
What advice would you give to players who are in that same position that you're in?
Honestly, it's just, for one, you know, just having that gratitude mindset, you know, just being grateful and thankful for where I am, you know, being here. And, you know, it's not always about, you know, playing so many minutes. And that's what I learned, you know, the biggest thing I learned last year. It was a very big humbling experience for me because, you know, I'm used to playing. I'm used to being on the court a lot. But like I mentioned before, you know, just learning from players that I used to watch and, you know, they're where I want to be at. So the advice I would just give is just, you know your role. You know, sometimes we may not play as many minutes, but there's so many things that we can do. You know, on the bench, you know, to still keep us, you know, present and focused in the game. So I just try to focus, you know, on being a good teammate, you know, trying, you know, be encouraging.
Yeah.
Because, you know, teammates need that, you know, sometimes he may be down. So I just try to, you know, give that spark in any way that I can, whether I'm on the court or on the bench. So just the advice is just, you know, keep your head up because your time will come. And when it does come, you know, just make the best of it. But always, you know, just know your role and just know that, you know, you're here for whatever, you know, whatever purpose and whatever reason it is.
So, I'm sorry. No, I was going to say, so basically you're saying, first of all, because watching from here, like, you always have the best attitude. You're always pumping your teammates up. So, you're basically saying stay ready so you don't have to get ready.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Stay ready so you don't have to get ready.
AB, what have you added to your game that you've seen since you have started playing AU Pro Women's Basketball?
One thing that I made sure that I did, you know, after the first season of AU was I got in the gym a lot more and worked on a lot of just, like, individual work, you know, like pick and roll stuff and, like, coming off screens and just, you know, taking more pull-ups because I noticed, like, last year, you know, if I do want to, you know, have a chance to play in the WNBA, then, you know, this is it right here. And just watching, you know, the way it's a much faster paced game. So my main thing was just, you know, getting in the gym and just doing a lot more like individual work. Cause, you know, I play pickup, you know, I can play pickup and go up and down all day, but, you know, just those little things, you know, working off like pick and roll, you know, being able to get it to a big or, you know, just reading the defense better. So I feel like, you know, that's the main thing that I made sure I went to just work on, which is more like that individual skill work and just reading the game better.
I like the sound of that. Thanks so much for
the
chair chat, a special feature here on Athletes Unlimited Pro Women's Basketball. We grab the players themselves while they are working in the game, and they take us behind the velvet rope. And I tell you what, AU Pro Women's Basketball is pickup on steroids.
Yeah, it is. Thanks, AB. Yeah, it is.
Jordan Canada pushing the Team Sims up a point. Davis doesn't get the finish. Plaisance, who's hit a couple of threes already in this quarter, getting it ahead to Lexi Brown for Team Hillman. Hillman posting up. Team Sims up by 3 points here in the second quarter of play, 19-16. Team Hillman won the first quarter. Plaisance missing the triple there. And here goes Team Sims looking to add to its lead with a little more than a minute to go here in the second quarter.
I love what Odyssey just did then. Last year, she probably would have attacked, not paying attention to the score, time and score, she would have attacked, but I love how she pulled it out and got her team in an offensive set in the half court.
So, first personal foul to Clarendon, and it will be Ty Young checking back into the game for Team Sims as Davis takes a seat. It's Team Sims with the basketball and the lead up 37-36 in the game and up 19-16 in the second quarter. Odyssey Sims off the mark. Battle for the rebound won by Plaisance. Plaisance is all, I'm not a guard.
No, she's like, no, I'll take one dribble. Somebody come get it.
The point forward thing, not my game. Hillman getting it to McCray, who's just checked back in. McCray off the mark, and JC picks up the foul. She can't believe it. She thought she had all ball. That's back-to-back plays where the guards on Team Sims, both Odyssey and Canada, were like, no, that's not a foul. That is good defense. Mark it down with a Sharpie.
Doesn't matter if I took her hand off.
New Athletes Unlimited Fantasy League is here. It's free and it's easy to play. Draft 4 players weekly and compete on the weekly leaderboard to earn prizes. Sign up anytime through week 3 and be entered to win an exclusive signed poster. Create your team today at auprosports.com/fantasy. And before you create that fantasy team, check out what Savannah Collins has posted on au.com, because she has the inside skinny.
Yeah, make sure if you're drafting for the fantasy game, Savannah is your cheat code.
Clarendon just off the mark. Hillman can't get the follow. Lexi Hull comes up with the rebound, and here comes Team Sims with the basketball.
Yes, girl.
Bell with the finish, giving Team Sims the 39-37 game lead, and now Team Sims up by 4 here in the second quarter. Team Hillman won the first quarter and the 50 points per player that go with it. Shot clock and game clock almost identical as the first half of play winds down. Lexi Brown trying to get free. Odyssey Sims is having none of it.
Listen, Odyssey is getting it done on both ends. I love how hard she's competing, and she is not letting Lexi Brown breathe.
So Clarendon setting the offense. Shot clock is low. Clarendon. A 3-point play opportunity the old-fashioned way, as they can add to their point total, now into double digits with 11.
Okay, Lay attacking from the top of the key by Jordan Canada. Kirsten Bell comes over, and Lay is able to draw the foul. Nice finish.
Clarendon has only missed 1 free throw the entire time here at AU Pro Hoops, and she's gone to the stripe the most of any player. In week 1, going 11 of 12. They get 12 of 13.
It has knocked them down.
Mm. And that's such an easy thing to do, right?
Oh, for sure.
Clarendon didn't think they were in the bonus. And that would have been a good foul had it not been a shooting foul, because you stop the clock, get them out of the rhythm, make them burn time, right? Because right now Team Sims has the quarter lead 21-20.
It would have been a great foul. Like, it's a smart play.
Yes.
I think everybody's a little confused. Is she shooting? Is she not shooting?
Yeah, because I think the scoreboard was inaccurate with the number of player foul, so it will be Jordan Canada at the stripe.
So they called an intentional.
Yes.
Yeah,
for
sure.
Intentional foul. So Canada at the free throw line, where she's shooting 88%. She gets that one to go, and it will be Team Sims with the basketball. So Sims with the quarter lead and is down 1 in the game. But right now, the scoreboard updates, so we're tied at 40. And Canada, off the mark, plays on, doesn't get it off in time. So Team Sims wins the quarter and the 50 points per player that goes to Team Sims. We are tied at 40 at the break. And Team Sims is cooking.
Yeah, and team Sims wins the second quarter by 2. Odyssey Sims is putting in work today. Nice, you better find her. Come on back.
The thought that keeps running through my head is, look at this thing we built.
At the beginning of this, I asked you, why do you play?
For me. For me. And it makes me think about the women who came before us, who never had this.
such a strong group of women who are role models, who have taken this sport to the next level.
If you had asked me to imagine what professional volleyball could look like in the United States, in my wildest dreams, I could not have described this.
Space to be free, to be supported, to be heard and valued. And with that said, representation is extremely important. Being a Black and Puerto Rican woman who is also part of the LGBTQ plus community, it is extremely important to be up here and be a role model for a younger generation, so.
For me.
For us.
Continue to play so the people below you have the opportunity to do this and have their life change the way we all did.
Because the question has never been, are we good enough? Are we interesting enough? Are we valuable enough? The question has always been, will you invest in us? Will you make space for us? Will you allow us the opportunities to be the heroes of our own stories? To be the heroes in the eyes of the next generation coming up?
For me.
For us!
Because we're ready. We have been ready. I hope that there comes a time that none of us are playing here. I hope there's a future version of this league that is filled with women who are living out the dream that we planted this last 5 weeks. And that we can come back and look in that book and see our names and see all of the names that came after us and say, look at this thing we built.
We are here in Dallas at Fair Park Coliseum. Great first half. Lexi Hall here, who's had 4 points, one block, and 3 rebounds to this point. It's a tie ball game at this point. Team Sims and Team Hillman tied 40-40. Team Sims coming in with Odyssey Sims having been a captain last week. And then Team Hillman with Nas being the youngest player in the league, each one taking a quarter. Very, very exciting stuff going on here in Dallas. Now, 6'1 guard Lexi Hall, you saw the highlight of her last week. She had 7 blocks in 3 games in week one, which is the record here to this point in this season here in Athletes Unlimited in Dallas. Now, she is someone who has been making every single moment count, so we had an opportunity to chat with her about what that looks like for her. Let's take a look.
Hall there for another rebound. Leaving it for Burton. Back to Hall for three. Who has also made 6 3-pointers today.
I see you, Lexi.
Every moment really does count. Every quarter you get points, every half. Every possession, every pass, you know, everything has a really important meaning in the scope of how you do here. And so for me, I think something I've been working on is being really efficient. Being efficient means making more shots than you're missing. Passing the ball, having more assists than you have turnovers. Having a positive impact when you're in the game. After each game, you'll be able to see that so drastically, I think, even more than you would have in a normal game, because all those points really matter.
Making every single moment count, and that she has been doing again. Setting a league high, 7 blocks in 3 games during week one last week. Now, the Stanford guard from 2018 to 2020 was the number 6 overall pick in the 2022 WNBA draft, went to the Indiana Fever, 2021 NCAA champion. Certainly has such an impressive resume and excited to have her here in Dallas. Looking forward to seeing what she's going to put together in the second half. Again, 1 block, 3 rebounds, and 4 points for her to this point in this game. Again, tie ball game, 40-40 with Team Smith and Team Sims having each taken a quarter. Now, the Unlimited Club provides great benefits, including weekly meet and greets and other league and player engagements, all starting at $20. You can upgrade to UC Gold and get a gold box, which includes great items like an exclusive jersey and a Natasha Cloud bobblehead. Sign up today at auprosports.com/membership. We'll be back with more after the short break. We have Nalissa Smith, an interview with her, the captain who won her last game. So stick with us in just a bit.
Was open, had the space. Cloud won't hesitate. That's pure. The foul line jumper.
Wants to go. Fourth quarter. Tosh Cloud with a head of steam, and she is going to the free throw line. Terrific patience from Air Hearn. Tosh Cloud answers with a three of her own.
Her teammates saying, reverse it, I got it. And I got that too.
Comes up with the block, Kella. She is on point. Under 3 minutes to go here in the first quarter, and it's a three from Tosh Cloud. Now, another chance for Team Carrington to cut into the lead, and Cloud does that. Tosh Cloud, anything you can do, I can do better. Cleans up her own mess. Cloud wearing orange, and Tosh comes up with a turnover. Cloud. How about that for the tie? We see you, Natasha. And here we go. Team Cloud ties the game again.
Cloud lets fly, long range, banks it in. Natasha Cloud from deep, 27-21. Team Cloud takes the first quarter.
Bodies go flying, and here comes Cloud. She's got some daylight, reversing well.
I appreciate the respect, but I promise I'm not there. There we go.
Okay, Tosh Cloud just hit her sixth three-pointer. Team Russell has some work to do with under 7 minutes to go. And nobody loves drawing a charge more than Natasha Cloud.
Oh, the handle's on Cloud. The dish to Carrington. Cloudy with a chance of dimes.
Sharing the ball defensively. They're getting stops.
Oh, she did not. What a flex by Tosh Cloud.
We are back here in Dallas, Texas at Fair Park Coliseum. I'm Mary Luce Cook with your halftime coverage. Team Sims and Team Hillman, each one taking a quarter tied 40-40 at the half. Now, last game, we have our MVP winners. Nalissa Smith, team captain, coming away as MVP 1, 28 points, 12 rebounds for her. Kelsey Mitchell, MVP number 2, her 12th MVP honor of her AU career, 20 points, 2 rebounds for her, and Isabel Harrison, who had 40 points and 12 rebounds. Nalissa Smith coming away with the win, and I'm excited to have her here with me. Nalissa here, courtside here at halftime. What a win for your team. First time captain for you. What went into drafting your team, especially when you had such a short period of time to do so and figure out who it was that you were going to take?
I just wanted to pick a lot of players I knew was going to play hard. So all the players I picked, they play hard. They have great leadership.
Now, you personally, another double-double for you. It just seems like that's the name of the game for you. What was working well for you personally in that last one?
Just getting to the rim, you know, getting to the free throw line. My team kept feeding me, so I kept trying to score it.
Now, that was a game that really came down to the wire. It was probably, I would say, the most exciting game that we've seen so far here. How did you keep your team locked in to the very last minute?
We just have a lot of people that, you know, collectively came together, played hard. You know, we all want to win. So, you know, we all come in with the same goal. We leave with the same goal.
Now, Kelsey Mitchell is someone that you and I were just chatting about. She was selected second overall in week two during the draft. You selected her. She was your first pick. Why?
Kelsey a dog. You know, I love playing with Kelsey. She's going to come out and play hard every single night. And I play with her in the W, so it just helps build our chemistry.
Now, with you being new to Athletes Unlimited, how have you enjoyed the experience so far?
It's fun. You know, it's something new every single day. I'm having a lot of fun out here.
Amazing. So much fun watching y'all play. Incredible, incredible game by y'all. Congratulations. Nalissa, thank you so much for joining us here at Halftime.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to take a short break, and we'll be back with more Athletes Unlimited Pro Hoops coverage for you.
It's hard to imagine that we're at the final week of the season, but we've got four captains who are ready to go. There they are, set to make their picks in this final week of year number two of Athletes Unlimited.
There's a pool of amazing players, elite players, top percentile players that we get to choose from as captains.
There are 14 players on each team, so each captain's gonna select 13 players to form their roster.
It's just such a like unique setup. You're all in on someone, I'm about to say their name, and then the person who goes right before you says their name and you're like, just kidding.
Trying to keep your secrets, trying to keep it close to the vest, but this is what makes it so exciting.
So much intrigue, so many storylines.
Our next choice is opposite Shayla Castro.
The internet just exploded. Larson and Shayla on the same team. Fantastic.
Fun, like playing that cat and mouse game of like, okay, who can I get? And then how can I, you know, just create the best team that I can create?
We've seen players step up that we may not have expected. We've seen other players that we thought, hey, maybe we thought they'd play better. So we'll see how this changes every single week.
We started with 44 athletes on the draft board. Now 44 athletes have been sectioned off into teams.
Those are your four teams ready to go this coming weekend.
If you could design a league from scratch, what would it look like? Athletes Unlimited is a network of professional sports leagues. This is an athlete-led organization.
The thought that keeps running through my head is, look at this thing we built. This is competition in its truest form.
McClenny lays out and snags it!
Puzo! McMahon score!
Nice move.
I see you.
In my wildest dreams, I could not have described this.
Welcome back to the Fair Park Coliseum, Dallas, Texas, home to season two of AU Pro Women's Basketball. The slogan is every moment counts. And to prove that to you, we have a do-over of the final 5+ seconds of the first half. Team Sims currently down by 1 point to Team Hillman, 39-40, instead of tied at 40. Let's bring in our replay official. His name is John Fullilove to explain to everybody what is going on. John, take it away.
Thank you. So what happened at the end of the second quarter with 5 seconds left? We had a common foul that was called on the floor, but we incorrectly administered the free throws. And so what we need to do now is correct the error, right? And we're going to bring all the same players that were on the floor. And Jordan Canada's one shot that she was given is going to be wiped. And we're going to give her 2 shots on a 1+ for penalty situation for 2 shots.
Okay, so the players, thank you so much, John. Alongside Cheryl Swoops, I'm Cindy Brunson. First of all, Cheryl, have you ever seen anything like this in basketball?
No, but I can think of plenty of times I wish we could go back and change things.
But it does impact a lot of things, right? It impacts the point total for Jordan Canada. Yep. She has an opportunity to hit two free throws instead of just the 1 point that she was awarded. So, again, the score right now, as we go back in time to 5.4 left in quarter number two, is Team Hillman on top, 40-39. And now Jordan Canada, instead of one free throw, will have an opportunity to hit a couple. She's got a 1-1. She is a terrific free throw shooter at 88%. So a terrific opportunity to give Team Sims even more points. It really doesn't matter for the second quarter point total because Team Sims won that quarter 21-20. So that doesn't change. It was 22-20. Only 1 point comes off, so they still have the advantage and get the 50 points per player for the quarter win.
Right. So my question is, what happens, because there's still 5.4 seconds, if Canada makes this free throw,
right?
They're up by three this quarter.
Mm-hmm.
Team Hillman will still get the ball.
They could,
so they can go down and
they can make
it
2-tie, and then the points would be split.
I was gonna say, and Plaisance would do it.
Right, she would. Ball goes out of bounds with 0.1 seconds, so all Team Gold is Odyssey Sims team has to do is get the ball in bounds. Then they will officially win the second quarter by 2 points instead of 1 point. And we stay tied at 40 because JC missed that free throw. I'm telling you what. Every moment counts. Every play, every opportunity to score points. And I love that the refereeing crew wanted to get it right. Our referees are Katie Bunger, Cam Garber, Grant Dietrich, and Team Sims did win the second quarter, 22-20. So they get the 50 points for quarter win number two, and Hillman got the 50 points for quarter win number one. We are tied at 40 points apiece. The teams have flipped positions on the floor now. And Team Sims in goal has the basketball. Lexi Brown almost coming up with the steal. It will be out of bounds with 12 seconds on the shot clock. And there will be a quiz after this game to determine if you were paying attention to find out what happened as we started the third quarter of play.
Multiple choice or no?
That's the best thing about sports, right? Best form of reality television is you never know what's going to happen.
For sure.
Bell off the mark on the three try, which is stunning because all she did was hit threes at the halftime break. It was ridiculous. She was like a metronome behind the circle. Clarendon spinning, meeting the defense of Lexi Hull, and Lexi forcing the turnover. That help defense was legit.
Lexi played for one of the best to coach the game in Tara Vanderveer. Mm. And one thing Tara is going to do is teach and coach defense.
Winningest coach all time in men's or women's college basketball. And ready to chase a fourth championship. The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship will take place here in Dallas. Super exciting. This is the place to be. Okay, JC. She's got 6 points and is looking for more.
Love how she just, first of all, just attacked. And she used her body and threw her body into, was it Alicia Gray?
I think so.
And drew the foul going to the free throw line.
Which is impressive because JC's got four personal fouls. So she's kind of got to be careful.
And I must have missed two of those fouls in the first half because I had no idea she had four fouls. But it's not going to change the way she plays the game on both ends of the floor.
No, but she can play with that many fouls. I've seen her do it at UCLA.
Some players can and some players cannot.
Right?
She is one of those players that can.
And what's the difference in a player like that?
Well, first of all, if you're an aggressive player and you're in foul trouble, you have to know how the refs are calling the game. So you have to adjust. But also just Listen, point guards are just smart players. Mm. And Jordan Canada is so mature for her age and just understands the importance of her being on the floor if her team's going to have a chance to win the game.
They with a pretty dime, and now Plaisance has 10 points. Oh, JC. Okay, she's got 8. Real quick. Team Sims with the lead, 45-42. The captain, Hillman, off the mark. Hull is there for the rebound. Odyssey Sims has her head up, looking for teammates in goal.
Sims. Had a move.
Oh, a little shake and bake. Plaisance says, hello, I'm a lot taller than you are.
Well, Odyssey got by her, but she brought the shot right back to Plaisance.
Lexi Hull with a nice finish. Mid-range jumper is pure.
Nice little shot fake. You know Alicia Gray is going to come out because Lexi Hull can just flat out stroke it from the three.
Plaisance, hello, I'm 6'5". Hello. Clarendon all tied up. JC going after that rock like her life depends on it. Shot clock getting very low. Hillman recognizing three on the way, in and out. Hull with another terrific rebound. Getting it to her captain, Odyssey Sims. Oh, thought about the three, puts it on the deck. Back to Bell. Bell around.
Oh, that's pretty.
Lexi Brown. It's going to be interesting to see Kirsten Bell's minutes improve with the Aces, because she has shown some stuff here in Athletes Unlimited. Team Sims up 49-47. Team Hillman needs time as a result. Lexi Hull continuing to prove that this is her league. Forget about rookie. Forget all about that. All right, so Team Hillman called the timeout. Cheryl, what do you think the discussion is in that huddle?
Defense, right? Your offense will come. You know I say this all the time. Offensively, everyone's going to miss shots. You can have an off night offensively, but you should never have an off night defensively. And because Naz Hillman is a defensive-minded player, I'm sure she, along with her facilitator, Simone Augustus, they're talking about what they're not doing on the defensive end. And a lot of the stuff that Team Sims is getting is wide open layups to the basket.
100%. I want to remind you to be there for championship weekend. The AU travel package includes 15% off tickets on March 24th and 25th, access to the AU fan room block at a hotel in downtown Dallas, and a meet and greet with a player. So go to auprosports.com/tickets to book today. Team Gold, led by Odyssey Sims, on a 9-2 run to start the third quarter of play. Big part of the reason why Odyssey Sims and company have a 7-point lead. So if you're in that huddle with Team Sims, Cheryl, is the message just keep it going? We like this.
Absolutely. And Jordan Canada, I think, came out the third quarter, and she really set the tone, being aggressive, even with the four fouls, attacking the basket, getting out, looking for her own to start this quarter. And Odyssey Sims is probably saying, this is the team I drafted. This is why I drafted this team. Let's keep doing what we're doing, and we'll be in good shape.
It is the first day of Women's History Month. We thank you for sharing it with us here at Athletes Unlimited Pro Women's Basketball. Cheryl, you're so accomplished as a basketball player, the first draft pick in the WNBA, the first to have a shoe with Nike. If you could have played in something like this, if AU Pro Hoops was available to you, would you have played?
Absolutely.
Why?
I love the style. I love the scoring system. It's exciting. And for me, I was always looking for a way to improve my game, to get an opportunity to stay stateside, not have to go to another country. And it's great quality basketball and great competition.
Naz Hillman out of the timeout, driving hard to the 10. Gets an and-one opportunity. The first-time captain making it happen.
You know, it's nice when you call a timeout and you can come out and execute whatever it is you talked about in the timeout. And Naz Hillman comes out attacking the basket, drawing the foul, going to the free throw line.
She's able to complete the three-point play the old-fashioned way. And now the lead is down to 4 for Team Sims in the game and here in the third quarter. JC getting it to Bell, who kicks it to Sims for three. Oh, that's nice.
That's pretty, Odyssey.
Odyssey Sims has 16 points to lead all scorers. Nas Hillman with a terrific take.
Well, again, I think, you know, it goes back to what we talked about earlier before the game with Team Sims, just the size or lack thereof. And Nas Hillman's doing a great job of taking advantage of posting Kirsten Bell down low.
Inside to play Zons. Nice find. She blows the bunny, gets the ball back. Can't complete the lay-in, and they're going to tick it home for the personal foul.
And Odyssey Sims, we talked about Jordan Cannon getting it done, and you can never forget about the captain. She's wearing that C for a reason. And Nas Hillman here, she squares up, goes right by Kirsten Bell for a nice layup. Easy two.
Plaisance not ready for the basketball, as she sees something on the floor that shouldn't be there. So that's why she wasn't ready for the hoop. She's got a little housekeeping in her and says, no, this shouldn't be on the floor. Somebody lost a contact lens or something creepy. And so Hillman deposits it on the bench. Great vision by Plaisance. I don't know if I'm seeing something that little on the basketball
floor. But how do you know it was creepy, though?
Well, if it's a contact lens, it came out of somebody's eye. So that's, in and of itself, kind of icky, right?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, so Plaisance missing the first one. She was an MVP one in week one. She went 4 for 6 from three and said to everybody, play is here for AU Pro Hoops. She gets the second one to go. So the team lead for Team Sims is 4 points here in the quarter. Here's a live look at our leaderboard, led by Kirsten Bell, 182 points. Maya Hollingshed has checked in for Team Sims, wearing gold. Lexi Hull dishing to Hollingshed. Stephon Plaisance blows the bunny, and Lexi Brown is there for the rebound.
Yeah, that's a nice take by Hollingshed. All she has to do is just take her time and finish. She had a nice wide open layup.
Another live look at the leaderboard. Hall charged with the personal foul. She knew it, nodding her head. She said, that's okay. I'm playing good defense. It'll be ball out of bounds on the side to Team Hillman. Lexi Brown will throw it in. Balik is on the floor. Gray. Air Hearn, nice bounce pass by Gray. Hearn, that's just shy of a three. And Jordan Canada, if that is on her, that will be her fifth personal foul. She's asking for a captain's challenge, and Odyssey Sims has agreed.
I don't think Odyssey agreed with it either. I don't know if it was a foul or not, but if I'm right. Jordan Canada, you can't even put yourself in that position.
Reckless closeout is what the call is that is being disputed by the replay. So let's bring in our replay official. He is John Fullilove. John, what are we looking at?
Ladies, we are looking at the last foul on Jordan Canada to be a look for it, by flagrant foul penalty one. Not allowing her to land in a safe space.
So that's not it. Only the personal foul, but a flagrant foul, which would be a shot and then the basketball. So this could be a big swing.
Yeah, we were talking about Jordan Canada being a smart player, and she is.
She stopped herself.
Yeah, but she didn't give air much room to land, and that's what they're calling. Air actually came down on her foot a little bit. It's a tough call, especially for a player who is doing everything for your team.
So let's kick it back to our replay official, John Fullilove. John, what do you have?
The defender, Jordan Canada, did not allow the shooter to come down in a safe space. So that will be a flagrant foul, penalty one.
So a flagrant one on Jordan Canada, in addition to, you know, that not being an ideal situation for JC, as we take another look. Because that's foul number five.
Yeah, the closeout was great, but she then got in her space and didn't give her enough room to land. And Thankfully, Air didn't turn her ankle because she landed on Jordan's foot a little bit.
The rule is in place to protect the player that is shooting the basketball. They want to have, like you said, a safe space to land in. And JC, despite the tippy-toe attempt, still impinged on Ahern's space. So that's the flagrant foul. It's foul number 5 on Jordan Canada, and Hearn goes to the free throw line. And it will be possession of the basketball to Team Hillman as well after the Hearn free throws.
So I'm wondering if Odyssey knows that Jordan has 5 fouls.
I would hope so. She is the captain. The facilitator is Carlos Knox. He's, I'm sure, aware of the situation as well. So 5 personal fouls, 9 points for Jordan Canada.
Yeah, and Jordan is a very valuable piece to Team Sims if they're going to have a chance to win this game.
So Team Sims up 2. Opportunity for Team Hillman to tie or take the lead. Baseline jumper doesn't fall for Lexi Brown. I'm going to guess it's because she wasn't behind the 3-point line. Hull with the finish.
Good look, Jordan. Good look, Jordan.
That's JC going, you going to call me a flagrant? I'm going to show you what I'm going to do.
But if you're Team Hillman, here's what you got to do. You, whoever Jordan's guarding, you have to give them the ball and attack her and see if you can't draw the 6th foul on her.
Bellick doesn't get the roll. Nas Hillman rebound put back, and they're going to ticket Maya Hollingshed with the personal. So we are all about being unlimited here at AU Pro Women's Basketball. It is Team Sims on top by 4. Woo, that's pretty.
Turning, shooting, 40. Tiana Hawkins, a brand new Athletes Unlimited record. Here's Hawkins to the hoop, lays it up, 2 more with 1.1 seconds left.
Colson from half court for the win! Colson was gonna end this game no matter what.
No, no, she did not. They want to get more players involved. And then
Carrington can't answer back. Lonnie Brown keeps it alive, and Cloud will hit and draw the foul.
All up in Natasha Cloud's face.
Making life difficult. She caught it, and that's a triple-double for Natasha Cloud, a history-making moment here in Athletes Unlimited.
Two minutes to go. Colson trying to go around Tosh Cloud, and does.
And at the end of the day, because they are professional athletes, competitors, it is all about pride.
Kelsey Mitchell, back iron, battle for the rebound. Tosh Cloud for 3, and it does not go, and that is how this game will end, as Team Hawkins gets the victory in triple overtime.
Four on her. Yep. Leash. Ooh.
Lexi Hull is such a smart player, and I hope folks at home are paying attention. If you talk in this game, you will play, period.
Yeah, and we're not even talking about what she brings to the team mm-hmm. and to the game offensively. Defensively, I love a vocal player talking to your teammates, making sure they know what's going on. And to have a teammate like Lexi Hull on your team who does it on both ends of the floor is definitely going to help Team Sims this week.
Big part of the reason why Lexi has moved into eighth place on the leaderboard that we just showed you. Nas Hillman trying to cut into this Odyssey Sims-led lead.
The only thing I wanted to see her do a little bit more of was in the huddle, dancing a little bit more.
Are you giving her negative points for dancing? Okay. You
lack
are harsh.
Thereof.
Ooh, Ty Young can't finish. Team Gold 6-for-11 from the floor in this third quarter.
Lex Brown has been a little quiet tonight.
Oh, she heard you.
I know. I thought she was going to shoot that
one. Ball goes out of bounds off Hollingshed and will stay with Nas Hillman's team. Team Hillman in purple down just 2 points on the overall scoreboard and on the third quarter leaderboard as well. Team Sims winning 14-12. The first quarter went to Team Hillman with the 50 points per player, and Team Sims won the second quarter in gold with the 50 points per player on the individual leaderboard. Ooh. Nice finish by Lexi Brown.
Pass by Mom.
Check that out. No, that wasn't Lexi.
Destiny.
Destiny Walker has checked into the game. Thank you.
It's the ponytail.
I was just going to say.
It is.
Jordan Canada doesn't get the roll. Hillman is there for the rebound. We're tied at 14 in the quarter and 54 in the game. Destiny Walker surveying. Hillman looking for somebody to move without the basketball. Puts it on the deck, beats Hollingshed, but terrific defense by Hull. You talk about a wonderful help defender. Gracious. Odyssey Sims. Oh, that's wet.
Lexi Hull making things happen on both ends of the floor.
Sims got 19.
Nice little handoff to Odyssey for a three.
Ahern trying to answer and does with a triple of her own. 17 points apiece for Team Sims and Team Hillman were tied in this game at 57. Odyssey Sims hits the deck hard. Ahern keeps her hand up knowing she got ticketed with the foul.
And it's typically Sims to Hull, but Lexi Hull turning her defense to offense. We don't see her pushing it much in transition, but here she does a nice job of pushing. Nice little handoff to Odyssey for three.
So Odyssey Sims leading all scorers. She's got 19 points on 3 of 5 shooting from three. The three-point shot wasn't falling for her in week one. A different story here in week two.
The three-point shot wasn't falling, and she was still at the top of the leaderboard.
In both points and assists.
Yeah.
She was straight fire. And the lash game, forget about it.
Between her and Dejanay, can't decide who has the longest and the prettiest.
Right. 20 points for Odyssey Sims. She leads all scorers, and you see her climb the leaderboard. Melissa Smith still on top with 2,042 points, but Sims picking up 10 points there for that last made free throw. Another turnover started by Lexi Hull. Hull with the handle.
Oh, that's
it. Nice vision. Young can't connect, but a terrific find from Odyssey Sims, who's been denied probably, what, 5 dimes today with misses easily at the
yeah
rim?
Yes. She should be in double figures with assists right now.
So Team Sims with a 1-point lead, 2 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Hillman loses the handle. JC is there and is on the run. Canada ahead to Hull for three. Oh, hello, Lexi Hull.
It's beautiful basketball. And then I love how excited Jordan Canada gets for her teammate.
Lexi Hull into double figures, and you see her climb live on the leaderboard from eighth place to seventh. Another turnover. Odyssey Sims with the finish. She's got 22. Oh, that's nice.
And it's contagious, not only on the offensive end, but defensively too. You had Lexi Hull, two nice defensive plays in a row. Odyssey Sims picking it up defensively for easy two.
The fast break point, 17-2 for Team Gold and counting. Under 2 minutes to go here in the third quarter of play. Team Sims on top, 23-17 in the quarter. Make it 26. Odyssey's got 23, and she is starting to cook with gas. Nas Hillman needs another timeout as Team Gold has found its groove big time for the second time this quarter. Team Hillman has to talk about it. What in the world can you tell your team when it comes to Odyssey Sims other than please face guard her up and down the floor?
Well, so here's the thing. The last play, Destiny Walker goes for the steal.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, you went for the steal with the wrong hand, so you got yourself out of position, and now it's a 5-on-4, and you're leaving Odyssey Sims wide open.
Mm.
That's a big no-no.
Right.
But there's a lot of basketball left, but it's a matter of pride in deciding that you're just going to shut somebody down. That's what Team Hillman has to come out of this timeout saying.
Odyssey Sims leading all scorers with 23 points. She was the week one leading scorer as well, picking up right where she left off. It's time for another season of Trees for Threes presented by Aspiration. For every three-pointer made during this year's Athletes Unlimited basketball season, Aspiration is committed to planting 10 trees. It's a 9-0 run for Team Sims over the last couple of minutes, led by the captain with 23 points, and the three ball is just her friend in this third quarter. 4 for 6 from three, 25 points.
And you know what's nice to see is the first half, particularly the first quarter, Odyssey and Jordan both did such a great job of facilitating, moving the basketball, trying to get their teammates involved. This quarter, they've come out on fire looking for their own, and that's the reason why Team Sims has this lead.
And the defense has picked up a tick, too. Inside, Hillman's not going to miss from there. Just beats the shot clock buzzer as the advantage is still 7 points in the game and in the quarter. Odyssey Sims cannot be denied as she will head to the free throw line with 25 points and counting to lead all scorers.
So Odyssey has some sick handles. It's like she has the ball on a string. It's like a yo-yo. She handles the rock. She, like, crazy. Like, it's just beautiful to watch.
Yeah, she helped Connecticut make the WNBA Finals last season. And, I mean, and that lefty stroke?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. I mean, even in traffic, just like watching her handle it in traffic and control it, it's so beautiful to watch.
She's got 26, looking to make it 27. In and out, so she stays at 26, but the lead for Team Sims, legit here in the third quarter. Clarendon, stutter step, and they're going to call her for carrying the basketball.
What? That never gets called in basketball.
Well, they just called it on they, so I think it does.
They do in AU.
Mm-hmm. So the lead stout for Team Sims, thanks to a big-time quarter. 27 points, and no surprise from an Odyssey Sims quarter. Remember, they had 38 points a week ago in week one, a Team Sims-led crew. So scoring a lot, not a surprise. Into single digits is the shot clock. Pull-up jumper, in and out. Walker comes up with the rebound, leaving it for Clarendon. Time running out, shot clock is off. As Team Sims is going to win this quarter. Lexi off on the three ball try. Ahead to McGuire.
who can't get the shot to fall, but still Team Sims wins the quarter 27-19. So that's back-to-back quarter wins for Odyssey Sims teams. Quick 100 points on the board with 10 more minutes to play. Do stick and stay.
Double for Natasha Cloud.
Courtney Williams buries the three. Here in the fourth quarter, Edelman again knows how to finish.
The champion converting. Hesitation dribble. Colson right to the hoop.
Plenty of time. Cole for three.
Kicked out, Custer loaded up, three ball. That's good. Jessica Custer has come to play.
To Lexi Brown, time on the clock. Good if it goes!
This is a special moment for everyone who's ever played volleyball in the United States.
Best players in the world with an opportunity to showcase the sport that they love.
And the fish.
Beautiful butter coming off the hand.
Athletes Unlimited volleyball happens everywhere.
Big dig there.
She can do it all. We are being treated to some exceptional volleyball.
We're using our voices, helping the voiceless. We stand for a cause, not fighting for straws. We changing the laws, we give it our all. It's a bigger picture, we paint the walls. We are unlimited, look at the game, we changing it all. We unified, on the front line, for the one time. Cause it's one grind, no divide. When we ride, use one voice, then we shine. Stand up now, unannounced. Hold on, hear me out, say it.
Essence Carson spitting the bars for us. Taking a look at the Athletes Unlimited leaderboard. Your top five shakes out like this. Melissa Smith in first place for now, because Odyssey Sims is coming. She has 26 points as her team Sims closed the third quarter on a 10-2 run. Odyssey leading all scorers in game number two of our doubleheader with 26 points on 4 of 6 shooting from three. I'll just let everybody know. Number 99's career high in AU is 32 points. She is not that far away.
Oh, she's gonna break that tonight.
Oh, okay. Mark it down with a Sharpie. Swoops has spoken. She has 26. Oh, what a beautiful dish. Lish with the finish. Nice start for Team Hillman here in quarter number four. Odyssey Sims with 11 20-plus point games career in AU. Clay Zantz with a beautiful block and tips the ball off of Davis to retain possession.
Like, I mean, a great play. Jamaris Davis, I did too, thought she had a nice, easy layup and place it not so quick. Not only do I shoot the thing, I play a little bit of defense.
6-5 in your face. Inside to Hillman. Davis right there. Davis just making life tough for Hillman. And Hillman gets whistled for the offensive foul.
That's good defense.
I know you like that. Sims and Lexi Hull combined to score all but 7 of the 27 points in the third quarter. That's a nice tag team.
Yeah, that's a great duo.
Sims off the mark from three. And this is McGuire triple. That's short. Hillman with the rebound. She's tired of watching these three balls go up in the air. Plaisance, the safety valve, getting it to Clarendon. They get it back to play for three. Off the mark. Odyssey is there for the rebound.
That's pretty.
Oh, Bell with the finish. Houston Bell now has got 14.
That is the type of point guard you want on your team. She always has her head up, her eyes up. She sees the entire floor that time. Nice baseball pass to Bell for easy two.
She is strong. It's not easy to throw a basketball that far. Let's check in with our sideline reporter. She is Mary Lou's Cook. Mary Lou's, what do you have?
Thank you so much. Well, I had an opportunity to listen in on what was going on in the Team Sims huddle, and Carlos Knox, their facilitator, was really happy with the job that they're doing on the perimeter. He said, excellent job to them, but the overarching message heading into the fourth quarter was do not let up, come out hot in the fourth quarter, which we're looking for now, and utilize the momentum that they had going out of the third into the fourth. Back to you, ladies.
All right, thanks so much, Mary Lou's. We have a challenge on the last foul call, and let's bring in our replay official. He is John Fullilove. John, what's going on?
We have a shooting foul called on number 91 for Gold, and we're going to replay that and take a look at it. Just give me a moment.
Okay, Jamaris Davis whistled for the foul on Nas Hillman. Davis said, I just took the basketball out of her breadbasket.
Well, that angle looked like a lot of ball.
Here's another angle. The only thing that might be at issue for Davis is that she brought her hand down, so it's like a swiping motion, and the referees always gravitate toward movement like that.
You are correct. I think my question, though, is from the ref that made the call.
Mm-hmm.
It came from the sideline.
Right.
So I don't know how she had
good line of sight.
Yeah.
Our officiating crew, Katie Bunger, Cam Garber, and Grant Dietrich. Let's check back in with John Fullilove. John, what's going on?
In replaying this particular drive to the basket, what we have is the defender makes illegal contact at the corner of the drive here. And the swiping down, she gets ball, but she has already made illegal contact on the drive as Hillman has gathered basketball for a shot.
With the body?
That is correct.
Awesome, thanks for that explanation, John Fullilove. A reminder, you can challenge play calls like that per AU rules. You get one challenge in the first 38 minutes and another challenge in the final 2 minutes of the first quarter or over time. So that was a good foul call against Davis. So Nas Hillman will go to the free throw line. Akilah Mays has sat down into our chair for a chair chat and joins us now. Akilah, what'd you think of that call?
That is not a good call at all. I saw ball the entire way. They said something about a corner. What does that mean?
That means at the top of the play, when Hillman first made her move, that was the contact they determined was the foul, not her swiping at the basketball. It was with the body early in the play.
What do you guys think about that?
Well, I have a question. So did you not like the call because it was against your team?
I didn't like the call because it wasn't a basketball. Like, it's not usually a call that I see. When I see the hand on the ball and the player has full possession of the ball about to go to the next way, I'm thinking, okay, great, defense.
All right, well, let's talk about, forget that call.
Well, let's say McGuire got the points to add to the Sims lead. Go ahead.
Well, I was just going to say, how has this year of Athletes Unlimited been different for you so far?
Yeah, well, I think just knowing what last year consisted of and coming in here, I actually talked to the new players a lot before we started the scrimmages, and I was just telling them, like, you know, it's a lot different type of basketball to play. So just kind of having a small leadership role. You know, even though I'm not in.
Don't say it with a question mark. No, you're a leader.
I am a leader, even though I'm like not a captain. I'm still on the bench. I'm still talking to players. You know, even if they're not on my team, I'm still encouraging them. So that's a lot different than last year.
I understand that when you grow up, you want to be a sports broadcaster. Is that true?
It is. Mm. I went to school.
Don't come this way.
No, wait, let me stack my 401k for just a few more years, and then I will pass the baton. How about that?
Yes, I would love to. Oh, my gosh. Just to do an internship or actually have, like, the opportunity to just speak, I would love.
We got you.
So, Akilah, question for you. Did you come into this season of AU setting goals for yourself of what you wanted to achieve this season?
Yes, I actually did set two goals that I'm hoping that I can hopefully accomplish in these next 3.5 weeks that we have.
Well, let's put it out into the universe. What are they?
Okay, so I want to be on the all-defensive team.
Ooh, okay. I like that.
Yes, but with the calls that they're calling now, I'm not sure about that, but I got you guys now. Next game. And also being top 20 on the leadership board.
Okay, those are great goals.
Thank you. Those are
wonderful goals.
Definitely try to reach them.
And you said you talk to the new players a lot.
Yes.
During scrimmages. Which newcomer has impressed you so far?
Ooh, okay, that's a really good question. I'm actually.
And you can give me three. How about that?
Three?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm definitely gonna go with my teammate Jordan Canada. She has definitely impressed me a lot. Just I've been learning a lot from her. So yeah. That's just impressed me, like her IQ and how she leads the team at the point guard position.
Uh-huh.
Also, the person who, look at my teammates, are like Keela. Nas has really impressed me.
It's a good one.
Just for her to be, you know, a newcomer and also like so young, she's definitely stepped into her captain role with just like a mature stance on like how she plays everybody and how she also plays the game herself.
Yeah.
Third one.
Think. You only get one more.
I know. I'm like looking at all the newcomers. I'm like looking on the court and I'm like, okay, I'm going to go with.
I give you one. Nalissa Smith.
I was just about to say that. She was my teammate.
I knew
teammate.
You were. Yes. I was reading your mind.
She was my teammate last week and she really impressed me on the boards and definitely having handles at her height. Because guarding her in practice, you guys, is definitely making me better.
Absolutely. And that's something that you should want. You should want to guard the best player or someone who's better than you that's only going to make your game better.
Yes, exactly.
What was it about playing basketball at NC State that prepared you for this pro run here with AU Pro Hoops?
Oh, that's a good question.
That's why I get paid the big bucks.
Well, you know, Coach Moore, I was his first recruit, so definitely having him all 4 years, he talked about playing tough and playing hard every possession. So whether it's on the defensive end or on the offensive end, just giving it 100%, I definitely see that a lot in my game when I'm playing on the court here. It's just keeping that energy, especially energy even on the bench. Like sometimes the bench is dead, but if you can encourage your teammates on the bench and give them that energy that they may be lacking, it can totally like change the game.
That is a great way to end this interview. Thanks so much for participating in the Chair Chat. Akilah Mays, appreciate the time. A Chair Chat is a unique feature here at Athletes Unlimited Pro Women's Basketball. And Cheryl has one more thing to say.
No, I was just going to say thank you. And let's go make those goals happen this season.
100%.
Yes, Cheryl, I got you. Thank you guys so much. I love you guys.
Oh, we love you
too. We love you back.
Top 20 on the leaderboard. I marked it down with a Sharpie. We're going to hold you to it. And we'll coach
you
up on the broadcasting as well. Air Hearn at the free throw line, able to convert. So the lead for Team Sims down to just 5 in the game, and it's Team Hillman winning this fourth quarter. So Team Hillman won quarter number 1 and the 50 points per player that goes with that, and now in position to win quarter number 4. Odyssey Sims, nothing but net. Ooh, she has got 31 points.
Listen, Odyssey, that is such a beautiful stroke.
It doesn't touch the rim. Mm-mm. Lish into double figures. She had a quiet night until this fourth quarter, but Gray has woken up and smelled the coffee. And a big part of the reason why Team Hillman has the lead, 14-11, Canada earning a trip to the free throw line. Oh, we've got another exciting finish for you.
Listen, and Odyssey Sims, I see you. I want to be you. Y'all better guard her.
Unlimited action here. Isabel Harrison, terrific take.
Isabel Harrison from the outside. Good to go, Izzy Harrison. Harrison on the move. The Euros switching hands and hitting. Izzy Harrison able to convert. Harrison, nice step through and gets the roll. Cross court, Harrison the fade and hits.
I love her footwork. Just Asha Cloud's hand, so she can make something happen.
Manis blocked by Harrison.
56-49 lead for Team Harrison. Izzy to the basket, takes the contact, hoop and the foul. The clock and out right into Harrison. Baseline jumper all net, so.
Add to the 11-point lead. Oh, okay, Izzy.
Well, she just timed it perfectly.
Harrison, bully ball again, can't be stopped. Izzy Harrison has come to play in this first half. Cross court, Harrison the fade and hits.
Carter bouncing to Harrison. That's puts nice. It on the deck, spinning and hitting.
Nice.
Harrison with some daylight. Oh, that was beautiful.
Harrison, nice step through and gets the roll.
That's on the run. Inside
nice.
To Harrison.
I just love the way she runs the floor.
She's got the double team and an and one opportunity. Harrison, you betcha.
Harrington, new player in Brittany Carter. She didn't play in game one, so it's nice to see her
that's
out
tough.
There.
In to Harrison, great position. Powers up over Manis and one.
Yes, this was just going at it down low. But Izzy says, you know what? You are not going to stop me this time.
Welcome back to Fair Park Coliseum. You are looking at images from our week one of play. Athletes Unlimited Basketball is brought to you by the Air National Guard. To learn how you can serve your way, head to goang.com. Team Sims on top of Team Hillman, and that is what they are playing for, to win it all and be atop the leaderboard like Tiana Hawkins was in year one of AU Pro Women's Basketball. Right now, Team Sims led by Odyssey Sims, who is leading all scorers with 31 points, and she is just 1 point shy of her AU career high, 32. How's she been getting it done, Cheryl?
I mean, facilitating. First of all, you get other people involved. They make shots. That's going to give you more space to get your own shot off. But she's 11 for 22, 5 for 8 from the three. She's scoring in so many different ways. That's tough to defend.
But it's not surprising because in AU Pro Women's Basketball, we've seen her drop a 30-piece 5 times now. 5!
That's easy.
Right?
That's easy. Yeah, that's easy for her. That's beautiful. Can we talk about the one at the free throw line, Jordan Canada? Almost a triple-double.
Mm-hmm.
7 boards, 10 points, 8 assists.
Yes.
I like it.
And it would be the second triple-double in AU women's basketball history. Natasha Cloud with the honors for the first one a season ago. Definitely something else to watch out for in the final 4 minutes and 24 seconds. Clarendon off the mark, point blank range. And here comes Odyssey Sims and company. It's Team Hillman with the 2-point lead here in the fourth quarter. Sims off the mark. That's about the only thing that hasn't fallen for her tonight. Clarendon,
spot on.
Their head up looking for teammates in purple. Team Sims, a 2-possession lead in the game. And
oh, okay, Bella.
Nice. So now the lead is 4 points for Team Hillman in this fourth quarter. Again, the winner of the fourth quarter gets the 50 leaderboard points per person for their individual leaderboard total. JC frustrated she lost the handle, taking it out on making sure she throws the ball out off of her.
Well, and even in hustling for the ball, I was like, don't push. Because let's not forget she has 5 fouls.
And she's been playing with 5 fouls for a good 10 minutes of basketball action. Lexi Hull for three. Off the mark, Hillman is there for the rebound. Hillman again stuffing the stat sheet. She's got a double-double with 17 and 12.
And that's just easy for her. She can do that in her sleep.
Bellick trying to get it into Hillman, but Ty Young is there. Young gets it ahead to Sims, who's 1 point shy of her career high, 31 points and counting. She looks at the game clock and the shot clock. And of course, on the scoreboard, the players can look up and see all of their numbers and exactly where they're at.
Yeah, look, just Odyssey just having the ball in her. Well, you can't go wrong with Odyssey or JC having the ball in their hands, because they're both so good at running the show and making sure they get everybody involved offensively.
Bellick and Ahern head to the bench. Jordan Canada, okay, JC. She's got a dozen points to go along with 7 rebounds and 8 dimes.
Nice pull up by Lay.
Clarendon is having her best game of AU Pro Hoops. 15 points, 7 dimes. JC, nice moves.
Izzy.
Bell off the mark. Claisance is there for the rebound. Clarendon looking to the sideline for a play. Nas Hellman's group down just by 4, but has the lead in the quarter by 4. So Team Sims winning the game and the 150 points that would go with that. But it's Team Hillman with the lead in this fourth quarter, 18 to 14. Ty Young picks up her third personal foul. And 5th personal foul on Team Sims in gold, so it'll be Claisance stepping to the free throw line. A reminder, we've got another doubleheader for you coming on Friday at 6 o'clock Eastern on WNBA's League Pass as Team Hillman will take on Team Harrison. And you know Izzy is not a happy camper. She drops a 40-piece and loses the opening game of week number 2.
It's so, the only thing that would have made her night better was to walk out of here with the dub.
So Team Harrison with adjustments to make as they will face Team Sims. And what you talk about, offense on display. Jordan Canada is able to induce the foul from Hillman. So the captain picking up her third personal foul. It'll be ball out of bounds on the side with under 2 minutes to go for Team Sims. Odyssey sitting on that 31. Lexi Hull.
Oh, what a tough Lexi take. Best.
Lexi Hull has 15 points and an opportunity for a 3-point play the old-fashioned way.
Listen, people always say the most dangerous person on an out-of-bounds play is the person taking the ball out of bounds.
Mm-hmm.
Lexi Hall throws it in, steps back in bounds, gets it back. Nice shot fake, tacks the basket, splits two for a nice layup and a foul. She didn't flex, but she walked out of there like, yeah, I just did that.
That's what I do.
Yeah.
She had that that's what I do vibe. 6'1 out of Spokane, Washington. Only weighs about 150, but it must be all muscle because she is tough.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, Lish.
Speaking of tough, dang, Lish. We see you into double figures.
She's looking for the foul, too. She's like, come on, ref.
Sims, a 5.5-point favorite coming into this game, thanks to our friends at Caesars Sportsbook. And Lexi says, I'm going to make that prediction come true.
Oh. I mean, just on the wing, putting it down, attacking. And Lexi Brown is a pretty good defender herself. But Lexi Hall said, not today.
Somebody has been in the weight room. Her strength from her first year with the Fever.
Oh, for sure.
Markedly improved. 6-point lead for Team Sims. And now, Team Hillman's lead in this fourth and final quarter down to just 2 points. So much on the line here with 1:25 on the clock. Hillman giving it to Brown for three. She's short. Rebound goes to who else? Lexi Hall. She gets it to Odyssey Sims, who's sitting on 31 points. Tried to get it to Bell. Great vision. And it will stay Team Gold Basketball led by Odyssey Sims. Out of bounds underneath. Who do you want to see getting the basketball here, Cheryl?
Well, I mean, you can't really go wrong. Jordan Canada, Lexi Hall. Lexi Hall. Oh, moving screen.
Jamaris Davis whistled for the moving screen violation, so the whole basket doesn't count. It was pretty, though, and we liked it, Lexi. Keep it up. Nas Hillman with an opportunity to add to this 2-point lead in the fourth quarter and the points that go along with it, a total of 50 per player. Up next Friday, March 3rd, Team Sims will face Team Smith in the second game of our doubleheader on WNBA League Pass at 8:30 Eastern. Jordan Canada almost coming up with the steal. Hillman recognizing, and a turnover. A steal goes back to Team Hillman. Bell denying Clarendon at the rim, but they will go to the free throw line.
Lexi Hall's all on the floor. She wanted her team to come up with that ball.
Clarendon directing traffic as they go to the free throw line. The best day at the office we have seen for Lay in her new AU Pro Hoops career. She has been stuffing the stat sheet, Cheryl.
Yeah, I mean, 15 points, 7 assists, and to your point, she has done a really good job from the beginning of the game, leading her team, getting involved, and also looking for her own a lot more today than she did last week offensively.
You can tell they took in week one, assessed, understood, surveyed, and now they get how the system works.
And it wouldn't surprise me, because Lay is that type of a player. If we don't see Lay moving up on the leaderboard, because she's so smart, and to your point, Cindy, she is learning this system, and she's definitely going to be one of those players to keep your eye on.
So is Lexi Hull, already with 4 steals tonight. She came into the game leading the league with 7 blocks. Odyssey Sims, 3 on the way, back iron, battle for the rebound. Ball goes out of bounds and will turn over. And we have a review on possession, which we can do with under 2 minutes to go here in this fourth quarter. So that is what the referee crew will be taking a look at. Our refereeing crew here in game 2, Katie Bunger, Cam Garber, and Grant Dietrich. And our replay official is John Fullilove. He has been fantastic, as we do have an official review. And we will check in with John. What do you have?
We have a call on the floor, out of bounds, awarded to Team Hillman. We're going to review that play and take a look at it.
All right. What do you see here, Cheryl?
I can't see from that angle. what looked like it was off on Naz Hillman, but I can't tell if Lexi Hall got her hand on it again, maybe?
Terrific camera work by our crew at Ross Productions, led by our director, Sydney Boxell, our producer, Casey Carter, statistician tonight, Jim Marchioni. Big thanks to everybody who has helped us bring you this doubleheader as we are about to put a bow on week two, day one play. Team Sims on top 87-83 with less than 30 seconds to go, but it is Team Hillman up 24-20 and in line to win those 50 quarter points, which they will win two quarters, which if you can't win the game, if you can win those quarter points, you help your own cause because every player on the roster gets those team points.
Absolutely, and that's why you see, regardless of what the score is, that's why you see players playing hard till the very end because they are all about securing the bag by winning every quarter if possible, but at least winning as many quarters as they possibly can.
And let's check back in with John. What is the ruling?
Per review of the play, the angles provided did not give us conclusive evidence that to overturn the call on the floor, so the ball will remain purple basketball.
Okay, so Team Hillman with the basketball and the lead here in this fourth quarter of play, up 24-20. I thought they were going to review and say, well, we don't know, jump it up, which would have made you happy because you love a jump ball.
I would have been all for it. I would have been all over it. I wish they would have come and asked me, though.
Yeah, they need to do that. You need to be the fallback on the review. If they don't know, check in with the Hall of Famer.
Oh, my gosh. I'm going to make everything a jump ball. Just toss it up.
Team Hillman with the basketball and the lead in this quarter. Team Sims with the lead in the game, 87-83. Odyssey Sims feeling it as a team captain, about to win a third straight game. Naz Hillman off on the triple try. Gray that goes down in a heap. Basketball will go to Team Hillman. Check that Team Sims will get the basketball. So Gray just fell and picks up the personal foul. That's a tough way
that
to get
that is a tough call, yeah. Gray was like, I tripped. I fell. And she was trying to get out of the way.
Okay, so it'll be Kirsten Bell to the free throw line as Gray argues her point to no avail. Bell getting it done from the free throw line.
Well, and here's why she's arguing the call.
Mm-hmm.
Because she does not want points to be deducted from her leaderboard points.
And she knows that the Hillman team lead is down to three now, and it could be two. Nope. Free throw miss. Battle for the rebound won by who else? Lexi Hall. Timeout is called. Odyssey Sims recognizing time and score in this quarter. With Team Sims down three, the timeout is called. So it will be gold basketball. Here's another look, Cheryl. What do you see? Check that. We're going to stay here for the whole free throw. There we go.
So that's just effort.
Mm.
Like, it doesn't matter who is boxing her out. She is going to outwork you regardless of what the score is because she wants the rock.
Lexi Hall makes it a one-point lead for Team Hillman in this quarter. Now, Team Sims is in position to win the game, but they could also pick up this quarter win with a defensive stand with 8.8 seconds. Let's go inside the game with Lexi Hall mic'd up. Lexi Hall is into this game and every game that she has played in AU Pro Hoops. 21 points, 9 rebounds, and perfect at the free throw line, Cheryl.
Listen, I wish there was a stat for hustle plays.
Because
she would win them all. Would be all over that.
But that's how she's climbed up the leaderboard.
Yes.
The blocks. She has 5 steals tonight.
Blocks, steals, rebounds, scoring. Should be hustle plays. I like how Odyssey Sims walked up to her and said, that's big girl basketball right there. And Lexi just smiles like,
right?
Yeah, I'm a big girl.
26 points. The last 4 games, single digits, then 26, then single digits. Now tonight she goes for 21. So Hull bringing it in her AU Pro Hoops debut. You know why they got the basketball to Clarendon.
Oh, she lives at the free throw line, and
they
she knocks them down.
They have been terrific. You betcha.
But listen, if you don't think Team Sims is trying to win this quarter, you're watching the wrong sport.
Oh, because Odyssey wants all of the points.
Yeah, she's greedy like that.
Well, who could blame her after
what? Yeah, I would be,
she
too.
She did leading Team Orange last week.
Yeah, she immediately says, no, 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 go get her, go foul.
And the lead for Team Hillman stays at 1 point after Clarendon uncharacteristically misses the first free throw opportunity. They make the second. So the lead is 2 for Team Hillman with 7.9 seconds to go. So Team Hillman with the lead, but now Team Sims with an opportunity to tie or take that quarter lead. They're already winning the game and the 150 points that go there, but now that 50 points on the line. So who do you think takes this shot?
Listen, first of all, they're going for the win. Mm-hmm. They're not going for the tie.
Okay.
Odyssey Sims has had the hot hand from the three, but Lexi Hull,
listen, she can shoot the 3, too.
I wouldn't be opposed to running some type of a 2-man game with Odyssey Sims and Lexi Hull, and whoever has the shot takes the shot. They're definitely going for the 3.
Okay, so Nas Hillman's team up 25-23 with those 50 win points on the line. Team Sims won the second and third quarter, trying to make it 3 in a row after Team Hillman won the first quarter 20-18. Team Sims in line to win the game up by 2 possessions, but the 50 quarter points are what Odyssey Sims and company want right now. 7.9 seconds to go, shot clock is off, and a travel is called on Jamaris Davis, and she can't believe it.
Nobody believes it.
Oh.
No. No. No.
And so Plaisance just running out the clock. Cheryl Swoops can't believe it. And that is how this game will end, as Nas Hillman's group is able to win the fourth quarter 25-23. And Team Sims wins the game 90-84. As Odyssey Sims makes it 3 straight wins as a captain dating back to last week. And Odyssey Sims and company win those 150 points for winning the game. What a terrific day at the office for Lexi Hull as she comes through with 21 points. 6 of 6 shooting at the free throw line, 5 steals, flirted with a double-double with the 9 rebounds as well. You just can't say enough good things about what happened with Lexi Hull and Odyssey Sims tonight.
I mean, from the very beginning, Odyssey did a great job of trying to get all of her teammates involved, but Lexi Hull come through. Just everything, offense, defense, hustle plays, on the floor. I love it.
Team Purple, led by Nas Hillman, dating back to last week, still winless here in Athletes Unlimited Season 2. Let's head over and check in with Mary Lou's Cook, who is standing by with Lexi Hull.
Thank you so much, ladies. Yes, I've got Lexi, and my goodness, Lexi, you were doing a little bit of everything tonight. How do you assess the way that you performed tonight?
I mean, I think more than anything, we just wanted to win. I just wanted to win, so whatever it takes at the end of the day.
21 points, 9 rebounds, 5 steals, 1 block, 1 assist. Again, doing a little bit of everything tonight. What kind of momentum is that going to give you moving forward this week?
I mean, every game, every quarter means something. So to take this intensity, this aggressiveness, moving it on to the next two games, I think is super important.
Amazing. And great continuity that you have there with Odyssey Sims as your captain again. What's that been like?
It's been great. You know, I just met her here, so I've been vibing with her. We're playing great together, so excited to keep moving forward.
Amazing. Certainly playing great. I'm going to let you go so you can go take your photo. Congratulations, Lexi.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
All right, back to you, ladies.
Thanks so much, Mariluz. Lexi, get into that game-winning picture, Lex. It's all about you. Her second 20-point game so early in her AU Pro Hoops career. What jumped out at you most and impressed you most today, Cheryl?
I mean, Lex, Team Sims, I love what she put together. So much of what I thought was going to hurt them by not having size did not prove to be the case tonight. But as a team, everyone contributed. Great win by Team Sims.
Odyssey Sims with those 31 points, one shy of her career high atop the leaderboard, and that's before MVP votes are tabulated, so that could change. But a great showing on day one of week two. Once again, our final score, Team Sims winning 90-84. Athletes Unlimited basketball continues on Friday night at 6 o'clock Eastern, 5 Central time. For Cheryl Swoops, Mariluz Cook, and our entire crew, I am Cindy Brunson. Thanks so much for starting the first day of Women's History Month with us. We are so glad that you are with us for season 2 of AU Pro Women's Hoop. Good night from Dallas, Texas.